Purpose. The reason for which something is done, or the reason for which something is created. The reason for which something exists. It's now approximately 1:30 a.m., the perfect time for me to continue writing my book. My creative energies seem to peak early in the mornings. As I picked up my pen, I could hear the tree frogs belching out their usual love screams faithfully, as if they were programmed to do so. The truth is, these tree frogs must keep mating to ensure the survival of their species. The loudest male will get the girls. The females simply cannot resist this call of nature. The louder the male, the stronger the male. And the females seek strong males to mate with for stronger, healthier offsprings. I thought about how animals lived under the law of nature, sticking to what they were designed to do. My wild imagination was triggered. Maybe it was the strong coffee that I was drinking, the rush of caffeine to my head maybe, but I began to think about how different things would be if animals had the same abilities as humans. The ability to use knowledge to improve the quality of their lives. Maybe humans would not be the dominant force after all on this planet. Can you imagine tree frogs with cell phones? Or a grizzly bear opening his own meat shop next door to you? What about snakes inventing legs and driving Ferraris? Hey, think about the cockroach in a full body protective suit, spraying us right back. Spray for spray then. Okay, enough crazy thinking for now. Let me put this coffee cup down. Animals operate under what I like to call the law of nature. Doing what they were designed to do. Living their purpose naturally without a choice. Humans, on the other hand, are designed with greater abilities. The ability to utilize knowledge to improve and expand. Amazing are the things we have already achieved, which is still just a drop in the bucket when compared to what we as humans can truly achieve. Whatever you conceive, you can achieve. Believe. I found myself in a somewhat frozen position, pen in hand, pressed up on the pad as if I'm writing, but really not writing. My intention is not to write a long, drawn-out novel, but to share my heart, not for fame. Definitely not to start a movement. Definitely not. Definitely not. The universe does not need another movement. I think we have enough religion to cover all the bases. A new religion automatically feels wrong. Rightly so too. I think we were hardwired to, after a certain time, sense nonsense. My intention is to share what I truly believe. Why? To encourage you, the reader or listener, to be true to your own self. They say that time is the true teacher. The first time I heard the saying, I totally understood its meaning and pondered if I would live long enough to appreciate life's many lessons. I don't know where this passion for truth came from. Maybe it was the lessons taught in Sunday school. But once this fire was lit, there was no stopping the inferno to come. After understanding what truth was, my desire to live it went beyond the Hebrew or Christian beliefs, supersedes the Muslim teachings, went way past Rastafari, and left Catholicism in the dust I realized very early in theological school that after being exposed to the truth and what truth is, you truly don't need a pastor or a religion to live your truth, because your truth cannot be dictated by another individual. Creation or the Big Bang Theory, whatever your take, was caused by something or someone, or maybe even a host of individuals or things. However, what happened did not need our input then and does not need our input now. Whatever happened and is still happening continues to exist regardless of all the opinions and the theories floating around. To stick to any one theory and call it gospel does not make it a fact, which is just my opinion. How can you be sure that whosoever came up with the theory is right? Isn't that person another human too? Why would the great power who started existence as we know it depend on humans, just one of the many other life that came into existence, to ensure its success or failure? Why? Humans coming up with the concept of being good enough to be saved or doing some kind of right thing is just another selfish, puffed up act, thinking too much of ourselves and using the power of knowledge to be more and do more than is required of us. Does this come as a surprise to the power that started existence as we know it? I'm sure it's not a surprise. Nor is it a deterrent to the purpose of it all. A mystery that will remain a mystery, not meant for us to solve. Without even knowing it, our purpose is being achieved, not because of us, but in spite of us. Night and day, life and death, man and woman, stars, moons and galaxies, all exist in spite of humans. We came and saw it. We had nothing to do with its existence. It's just like death as we know it. Even the rich die. The powerful, the fearless, the ones we call scholars, all must surrender to death. A force that is greater than us. Age and time, another reality we all must face. All these and more exist in spite of us and our beliefs. What I like to call the truth. The sound of the garbage truck outside was annoying enough to snap me out of my deep thoughts. What time is it, I wondered, as I got up to check my phone. It was now 6:40 a.m. Another sleepless night, sitting up meditating on purpose. Understanding and appreciating truth. As I turned down the fire under the kettle, I thought to myself, does this truth nullify hope? If we understand that we are here in spite of us, fulfilling our purpose regardless of us, will this bring about chaos? Definitely not. Purpose will not allow it. The three frogs by now was totally silent. Maybe they all got peered up and was doing the love rock. Whatever they were doing, no screaming was required. I looked at my pen and pad and realized that I did not write a single word. I chuckled to myself that tonight I am definitely going to start this damn book, knowing deep in my heart that I might not start writing tonight. But at the same time, I did not feel guilty or pressured by some kind of unnecessary preset standard, and that gave me inner peace. After all, I am only human. Thank you.
Thank you.